Hey everyone, it is Josh here with HostGator. Today we are excited to show you how to build a new WordPress website from the ground up. In this series, we'll help you take your website from looking like this to looking like this in just a few easy steps. Today we're going to focus on how to create and edit a new page inside of your WordPress dashboard, and we'll show you how to edit an existing one to add content for your visitors to see. If you need to get caught up in the series, I've got links to them in the description below, but if not, let's get started. Now we're kicking things off once again inside of our WordPress dashboard. This time on the left-hand side, we're going to find the Pages icon and click there. And this takes us to our Pages section inside the WordPress dashboard. As you can see, all the pages that we have for our site are currently listed here. Now there's not too many since we just got started building, but these can add up very quickly, so be sure to note on the top right-hand corner, there's a search bar where you can easily search using keywords for any of the pages that you have. Now, before we get started on creating and editing any content, it's really good to note the difference between a page and a blog post. Blog posts are essentially blog-like content that's listed in reverse chronological order with the newest content at the top. These posts are usually present on your blog page, and we'll talk about that in a completely separate video. Pages, however, are static content, such as your About Us, your Privacy Policy, and your Contact Us pages. These are generally in a place where your content, like images, texts, blogs, posts, videos, and more, can be displayed. Pages are individualized, and you can add as many and link to them as much as you want. So I know that I want an About Us page for this site, and it looks like the one that comes default with this WordPress theme magically disappeared. I wonder how that happened. Now that we know what we're working with, let's take a look at some of the options that we have within the Pages section to actually modify content. Let's hover over one of the existing pages here, and I'll show you some of the options that we have. So I can hover over the contact page here, and we can see that we have an edit, a quick edit, a trash, and a view. Now the edit button is going to be the best way to physically edit the content of your site. There's a quick edit option, but that really just deals with the date, slug, title, and a few other key details. The trash is exactly what it sounds like. If you want to delete the page, that's exactly how you do it. And view is if you want to see how the page actually looks. Now that we've seen some of the options, let's take a look at the pages that I actually have. We've got my blog page, which is my post page, so any blog post that I make will automatically show up there. I've got my contact page, a privacy policy page, a sample page, and my front page, which is the one that comes default with a WordPress 2020 theme. We'll move into editing shortly, but first let's learn how to create a brand new page. In the top left-hand corner, there's a button that says Add New. If we want to add a new page, let's click here. Welcome to the WordPress page editor. Now there's a new block editor in WordPress this year, and if you need a tutorial on that, you can go ahead and click the next option down here. I'm going to show you a few things about the block editor too, so we'll go ahead and exit out of this. Now this is going to be my About Us page, so the first thing I want to do is add the title. We'll click here under Add Title, and we'll type About. Now below the title, we'll have the option to either start adding text or choosing a new block. I want to show you a little bit about blocks because they're one of my favorite parts of WordPress. So let's click here and click the plus sign. A little while ago, WordPress started to get really good with their built-in page editor, and I love the block feature. Once we click on the plus sign, you can see that this navigation bar opens up to have a ton of different blocks available. What I'm going to do now is choose a block that's right for me. As you can see, we've got paragraph, image, pull quote, gallery, heading. There's a ton of options here, and we're going to go over a lot of them. The first one I want to do is some really bold text, so I'm going to choose pull quote. Now that I clicked pull quote, I've got the option to either start adding text manually, or I can paste in some of the text that I have on the side. I've got mine copied over here, so I'm going to paste this in. Now I can see that I've got a pull quote here with some great information at the top of my page. Now that I've got my text in place, let me show you a few things about the block editor. Up here on the top, I can either choose the different type of block style, I can change the type of block that's in use. I can change the alignment if I want to align it to the left, to the right, to the middle, or go full width. I can also change some things about the text if I want to go bold, italic, or add a hyperlink. I can also choose inline code, strike through, subscript, and a bunch of different text options here as well. Now that my first block is set, I'll click out of this, and all we need to do is add a new block. So let's create another one by clicking on the plus sign again. Now let's look at some additional block features that we have. I've got six options here, but if I click Browse All, you're going to see a bar open up on the left-hand side that has a ton of different options. I'm going to scroll down until I find the one I'm looking for, which is Columns. Columns are one of my favorite types of blocks because they offer tons of different customization options. As you can see, you have a bunch of different options here. I've got two columns, 50-50 width, 30-70, 70-30. Let's go with 50-50 for an even split. As you can see here, I've got two new blocks now. I've got one on the left and one on the right. Now I think what would look great here are two images right next to each other. So on this left-hand side, I'm going to click the plus, and now I'm going to add an image block. Adding an image is easy because I can click upload here to upload a brand new one, or I can go directly to my media library, or I can insert one from a URL that's already online. I've got some stuff preloaded in my media library, so let's click there. I like this photo of my dog Leah, so we'll click this one, and we'll click select. Now I've got one image here, I want to do the exact same thing on the right hand side. I'm going to click that plus again, click image, right back to my media library. Now I'm going to choose a photo of me. Choose that one, click select. Now I've got two images there and I think they look great. All I need to do now is click outside of either of these blocks. And now I can hover over them and click each individual block if I want to. Now I can change the size, edit if I want to, and I want to add a caption down here at the bottom to give them some information about what this picture is. I'll click in here into write caption and I'll copy over some of this text that I've got. Do the same thing on the right hand side. Paste that in. Now I've got two pictures right underneath that pull quote, and I think they look great. Now the next thing I want to do is start to add some design touches to this page, and I want to break up the content a little bit, so I'm going to add a new block. Click the plus sign here. The next thing I want to add is called a separator block, and this is just a basic line that kind of breaks up the text and the images on my page. As we can see here, just clicking it, I've got a new line that's added to the page. If I want to extend this beyond the middle of the page, I can click this option here, change block type or style. And we've got a wide line option or a dots option. I'm going to choose the wide line because that's going to stretch all the way across the page, and I like the way that that looks. One of the things I like most about blocks is that they're super easy to move around the page. I really like the way that this looks, and I want to add a new one. So I'm going to click on this block here, click these three dots for more options, and then I'm going to choose the duplicate option. So now I just essentially made the same block twice. Now I'm going to click on this bottom one, make sure it's highlighted, and then I'm going to choose this arrow that says move up. So this is essentially going to allow me to move this up the page. As you can see, I'm slowly but surely moving it above all the other content. Now I've got a separator block at the very top of my page, and I think that looks pretty nifty. Last but not least, let's head down to the bottom of the page and add some text to tell visitors a little bit more about who I am. So we'll scroll down here and we're going to add, you guessed it, another block. I'll click here. This time I'm going to add a paragraph. Now that it's up, I'm going to paste in some of the text. As I mentioned earlier, you can always play around with the text options here if you want to go bold or italic. I'm going to click out of that. Just scroll around and see how that looks. I think this looks pretty great so far. Now that we're done editing the page, the most important thing you can do is up here in the top right hand corner, once you're done, click publish. Make sure that you do that, or you can save it as a draft if you're not ready to take it live. Either way, make sure that you save your work before you get out of it. So I'll click publish. Before it allows you to publish, it's going to ask you to double check a few of the settings here. The first thing it's going to ask you to look at is the visibility. So you can see if it's public, private, or password protected. I'm fine with this being public, so we'll leave it as is. And the next thing you can do is publish immediately. You can also choose down here if you want to schedule this page to be pushed on a certain date or time. I'm going to leave that to immediately for now, so we'll scroll back up to here and click publish. At the bottom left-hand corner, you can see that the page is now live. I'm going to click view page. And here's my about page. Scroll down just a little bit, and I think that looks pretty awesome. And that's about it for creating a new page and adding content to it. Stick around for our next video where I'm going to show you how to make menus, widgets, and a whole lot more. As always, if you found this content helpful, please tell us in the comments below, give it a like, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.